I've heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing alleluia. Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to a kitchen chair. She broke your throne and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the hallelujah. 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 Say I took the name in vain. I don't even know the name. But if I did, well, really, what's it to you? There's a blaze of light in every word. It doesn't matter which you've heard. The Holy best, it wasn't much. I couldn't feel, so I tried to touch. I've told the truth, I didn't come to fool you. And even though it all went wrong, I'll stand before the Lord of song with nothing on my tongue but hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Christina Louise Looy was born in 1957 in Radway, Alberta, to John and Katherine Buryn. Mom affectionately referred to herself as the middle child of the family. Her siblings, Lorraine, Lorne, Don, and Bill, would describe her as the glue that kept their family so close. Their family bond over the years always remained strong. Throughout Mom's entire life, her priorities of family and faith never wavered. Her faith was steadfast and radiated in everything she did. She had many godchildren and was always involved in the church. Mom lived every moment of her life for her family. Auntie Lorraine remembers when school was out for the summer. It was the very next day Mom would set up her school in the back garage. She would have her own classroom prepared and have all her worksheets ready. There was school year-round in the Buryn household, thanks to Mom. Mom loved to read. Her siblings remember her climbing up to the top of the closet and reading for hours. This love of reading went on to inspire her to teach children. She particularly had a special place in her heart for students who struggled to learn.
Mom and Dad met through their mutual friend circles. Everyone talked about the many dances, social functions, and curling bond spiels. Mom laughed that she agreed to go out with Dad because she didn't think he was into sports. Well, little did she know, sports would become a huge part of their family life. Mom and Dad's connection was instant. She loved how calm and chill he was about everything. They dated for a few years and got married in July of 1979. Mom started her teaching career in Cold Lake. They always knew they wanted to move back home. Within 1 year, they had moved to St. Paul, and Mom started teaching at Reset School. She was there for 30 years and truly made an impact on everyone she worked with. It is incredible how many people will tell us she was their favorite teacher, and in their words, she was the kindest and most caring teacher. We joke that we don't know how she survived that many years in junior high, but she loved it.
Shortly after starting her teaching career, Mom and Dad decided to start a family of their own. I was born in 1983, and Christopher followed in 1986. Growing up, Mom had high expectations of us. Although she was firm, she was always a safe and stable support for us. We always knew we could come back home. Her love was unconditional, and she supported us through all of our endeavors. We were the center of her world. She would do anything for us. All our friends affectionately call her Mama Chris, as she would always be willing to pick us up from any event. She would roll up in her teal minivan, and we would all pile in. She loved coming to get us and would laugh about the stories for years after. Our friends were important to her, and she always enjoyed making connections with them. Dan entered the family in my teenage years. At first, Mom was leery as she knew this boy from school, and he wasn't exactly the A student or the rule follower. But through the years, she grew to love him and realized what a great, strong support he is and how he took on being such an amazing dad to our boys.
Mom came into my life at the impressionable age of 15, the age when you need all the mom help you can get. I felt welcomed, secure, and loved right from the beginning. She always gave the best hugs and advice. She gave me the strength and guidance I needed at so many of life's challenges and milestones. She called me her angel, but in reality, she's always been mine.
Becoming a grandmother was Mom's greatest life accomplishment. When Linken entered the picture, he became the center of their universe. I'll never forget the day he was born. She waited in that waiting room for 7 hours to hear his cry. From that point on, they were inseparable. 2 years later, Reid arrived, and she always had a soft spot for him because he became a middle child, just like she was. They would spend a lot of time together bonding over reading books and baking cakes. Dylan entered the picture exactly at a point when we all needed him. He was born in the middle of Mom's first battle with cancer. He was the ray of sunshine, and when she wasn't feeling good, we would wrap him up and tuck him in the bed with her. These three little men became the reason for her being.
Life became even sweeter for Mom when Chris and I had our first baby, Avery, and very soon after, Rosalie, finally her grandbaby girl. We were eternally grateful that she cared for Avery and Rosalie through their infancy while I went back to work part-time. She showered them with hugs and kisses. We were glad the Mahe boys prepared her for Avery's energy and zest. She would admit that she was tired, but it was the best kind of tired, she would say. We believe Rosalie is a little grandma, confident and affectionate, and knows what she wants. She loved them so deeply, her eyes lit up whenever they came around. Over the years, Mom loved to travel. Her adventures started in grade 12 when she traveled to Paris. Mom and Dad celebrated their 25th wedding anniversary in Hawaii and returned numerous times after that with family. Mom loved the sunshine of Arizona, where she would go and visit Uncle Lorne and Auntie Leia. She wished she could spend longer, but she could never leave us kids for too long. We were fortunate to share many family holidays. Mom and Dad never insisted on their own agenda. Their focus was solely on spending time together and making memories.
Christmas was Mom's holiday. The planning and preparation started months before the event. She loved watching the kids' faces as they would open their mountain of presents. She loved the traditional singing of Christmas carols at Grandma and Grandpa's house around the piano. Her whole life, she enjoyed music. After Grandma Kay's passing, Mom took over being the matriarch of the family, organizing all of the family holidays and making sure the family always stayed together. Mom, you were the foundation of our family. You left us with a legacy of love, faith, and family to continue. Mom, this is not a goodbye forever. We can already feel you in our hearts. We know you're smiling up in heaven alongside Grandma and Grandpa watching over us. Rest easy, Mom. We love you.
Please rise.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Blind, but now I see. taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace, unending love, amazing grace.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. On the day of her baptism, Christina was welcomed into the church, given new life in Christ, and clothed with the garment of salvation. Today we greet the body of our sister and surround her with the church's prayer. We commend our sister Christina to the mercy of God and pray that the promise made to her in baptism will be fulfilled. Let us pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Christina, whom you have called to journey to you. And since she hoped and believed in you, grant that she may be led to our true homeland, to delight in its everlasting joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. And let us be seated for the reading.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The righteous, though they die early, will be at rest. For old age is not honored for length of time or measured by number of years. But understanding is gray hair for anyone, and a blameless life is ripe old age. There was one who pleased God and was loved by him, and while living among sinners was taken up. Such a person was caught up so that evil might not change their understanding or guile deceive their soul. For the fascination of wickedness obscures what is good, and roving desire perverts the innocent mind. Being perfected in a short time, they fulfilled long years. For their soul was pleasing to the Lord, therefore he took them quickly from the midst of wickedness. Yet the people saw and did not understand or take such a thing to heart, that God's grace and mercy are with his elect, and that he watches over his holy ones. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am already being poured out as a libation, and the time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day. And not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Sometimes we may find ourselves to be like those in that first referred to in the first reading who don't understand why the someone that we love and care about are taken away so suddenly, so quickly. And yet the Word of God reminds us that the Lord has a plan, a loving plan for Christina, for each one of us, for our good, for our salvation, for eternal life. The gospel as well gives us some perhaps challenging statements that we wouldn't normally consider. Blessed are the poor in spirit, those who mourn, the meek. They will be blessed. They will be happy. Important thing is that while life is good, we aren't to be so attached to this earthly life that we forget our eternal calling, our eternal destiny. I met Christina in the hospital the day before she passed away. And it was clear that she loved her family, she loved life. But she was ready to let it go. She trusted in the promise of Christ, who said, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are the pure in heart, they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God." She understood that if her time in this life was over, life itself was not over, but changed, and to be with the Lord in heaven. I had the privilege of celebrating three sacraments with her: reconciliation, the anointing of the sick, and Holy Communion. She understood that as the Lord was calling her, she needed to prepare herself to meet the Lord face to face, the Lord who is her Father, her Savior, her Redeemer. When I was discussing with the family on Friday about the readings, one reading that stuck out to all of us was that second reading from St. Paul's letter to Timothy. "I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith." That is, St. Paul is the model, but that's what all of us are called to do each day of our life, to fight the good fight, to finish the race, to keep the faith. "From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who longed for his appearing." This promise is also for Christina and for each one of us who strive to keep, to fight the good fight of the faith and to keep the faith. May we too, today, as we acknowledge our grief in our loss of mother, sister, cousin, friend, that as she hoped in Jesus Christ and in the end resolved to put herself fully into the hands of our merciful and loving God, that we too can do the same. For death, life is not ended, it's merely changed. Where those who are faithful to the Lord are truly blessed, are truly happy, living in his kingdom. May we be inspired and uplifted by the hope of the promise of God's faithfulness of eternal life. And let us pray for Christina that she may now enjoy the eternal rest given to her by the Lord. Please stand, and we will now have the prayers of the faithful. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. And the response will be, hear our prayer.
In baptism, Christina received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Our sister Christina was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Christina seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Christina. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And please be seated for the offertory.
Number 35 in your glory and praise, blessed are they. Number 35 in your glory and praise.
Blessed are they, the poor in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed are they, full of sorrow, they shall be consoled. Rejoice and
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Please stand. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Christina, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis, our Pope, Paul, our Bishop, Gary, our Bishop-elect, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Christina, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. With you. Peace with you. Peace with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For communion, you're all welcome to come forward. We will have four ministers of Holy Communion. If you are not Catholic or not prepared to receive communion at this time, just simply put your hand over your heart and we will gladly give you a blessing.
Number 137 in your spirit and song, the summons. Number 137. Number 162 in your spirit and song. Lord, you have come. Number 162 in your spirit and song.
Lord, you have come to the seashore, neither searching for the rich nor the wise, desiring only that I should follow. Oh, Lord, with your eyes set upon me, gently smiling, you have spoken my name. All I longed for, I have found by the water at your side. I will seek other shores. Lord, see my goods, my possessions. In my boat you'll find no power, no wealth. Will you accept then my nets and labor? Oh, Lord, with your eyes set upon me, gently smiling, you have spoken my name. All I longed for, I have found by the water at your side. I will seek other shores. Lord, take my hands and direct them. Help me spend myself in seeking the lost, returning love for the love you gave me. Oh, Lord, with your eyes set upon me, gently smiling, you have spoken my name. All I longed for, I have found by the water at your side.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Christina may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Christina shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May she be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. As a sign of respect for our sister Christina, we let this incense rise to God, who has called her to share in his glory.
May songs of the angels welcome you and guide you along your way. May the smiles of the martyrs greet your road as darkness turns into day.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Christina in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Christina in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. Amen. Dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. And in peace, let us take our sister to the place of her rest.
Number 154, I know that my Redeemer lives in your spirit and song. Number 154.
I know that my Redeemer lives, the one who calls me home. I long to see God face to face, to see with my own eyes. I know that my Redeemer lives. I know that I shall one day see the goodness of the Lord, when God will wipe away your tears and death will be no more. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall rise again. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall the last day I shall rise again, shall be remade like God. My home shall be by God's own side, the dying rising Lord. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall
you'd ever say goodbye, and now I'm glad I didn't know the way it all would end, the way it all would go. Our lives are better left to chance. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to the dance. Holding you, I held everything for a moment. Wasn't I the king? But if I'd only known how the king would fall, hey, who's to say? You know I might have changed it all. And now I'm glad I didn't know the way it all would end, the way it all would go. Our lives are better left to chance. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the dance. It's my life, it's better left to chance. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the dance.
For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life, for all the wrong that you made right, for every dream you made come true, for all the love I found in you. I'll be forever thankful, baby. You're the one who held me up, never let me fall. You're the one who saw me through, through it all. You were my strength when I was weak. You were my voice when I couldn't speak. You were my eyes when I couldn't see. You saw
Give us faith, so we'll be.